Hi there, my name's David Earle, and I've been invited here by EastWest to talk to you about Play 5. Play 5 is a major performance upgrade to the fastest Play version to date. It's got an optimized engine, the load times have been dramatically improved, and you're really going to love the way that it works with SSD and PCIe flash-based storage. In addition to that, we get 726 additional reverb impulse responses, and then we get the SSL global suite on all libraries. And on Goliath, we get an amp simulator and Omicide, which previously were just on Ghost Rider and Pro Drummer. Personally, I'm really excited about the new changes and additions that they have in Play 5, and I'd like to explore them with you and show you just how powerful they can be in your creative workflow. So if I go to the browser, and I'm going to go to my Hollywood Strings Diamond First Violins Long Powerful System Round Robin Sus13. So this is one of the larger libraries that you can open up in Hollywood Strings, and I'm just going to double click on that. All right, now you may have blinked and missed it, but it loaded the entire violin library there, and that used to take a lot longer. Now the reason that it's loading so fast is because the cache settings have been improved within the Play engine. If you go to your settings and streaming, you'll see that the sample cache is actually, well, I have two drives here, and it's pretty neat. You can set them for individual drives. So I have some libraries on this drive, which is a regular hard drive, and then I have this one that's SSD. So even though this is 7200 RPM and all that jazz running off a SATA, I still put this cache a little bit higher so that I'm loading some of the sounds into RAM. That takes a lot of the stress off of the drive. But with SSD, I can really stream the samples off of the SSD much more efficiently, and the load times are like amazingly fast. So I set that lower. Now you may want to look into the documentation to see what's going to work best for the hard drives and the type of connection that you're using, whether it's USB 3 or eSATA or PCIe, whatever you happen to be using. Those settings are really important for how you're going to optimize load times. My really large orchestral template now loads incredibly fast. So this is a really huge improvement for me. I love this. The other large change that has happened is that if you go into the mixer and hit effects, on any library that you open, you will see the SSL plugin suite. This is, I mean, it's amazing that they're including this in Play for every product, because what you're getting is an SSL console. You have the SSL channel strip, which gives you compression and EQ and transient shaping. And then down at the bottom, you have a stereo bus compressor, which is a lot like the G-Series bus compressor, or what my producer friends like to call the good knob. You just push it, and all of a sudden, things sound better. We also get a convolution reverb that's included on all products, which is pretty rad. Additionally, if you have Goliath, Goliath is this really awesome set of sounds that's been collected from all of the different EastWest libraries so that you have essentially a synth with sort of a best of EastWest. And they added something really special in here. If we go into, say, an acoustic drum kit, I'm going to load up this vintage 60s kit. If I go into the mixer here, not only do we get all of the SSL goodness, we also have an amp simulator and Omicide. Okay, so the amp simulator, we're able to choose between all these different models of amps. Turn the power on. And we can drive it, we can change the EQ, we can choose pre or post, whether it's, you know, how it's going to be placed with the SSL channel strip. And it actually moves, which is kind of cool. Wet and dry, and then your master. And this is a really neat amp simulator. So that's kind of neat that we have that for all of the Goliath instruments. So imagine it can be from pianos to choirs, to drum sets to the guitars, and you get all of the amps in there, which is really neat because that used to be limited to just the Pro Drummer and Ghost Rider. But now we have it in Goliath, which is awesome to have it on all these different instruments and have that sort of saturation. Then Omicide, I mean, this is really nuts. Omicide and Amp Simulator really give you a lot of flexibility as far as saturation and tone shaping and distortion. And I had a little bit of fun with it, and I wanted to show you some examples of how I use it creatively. So if I open up the play engine here, I'll show you what this bass sounded like originally. Now, I'm going to turn on the amp simulator. So it's a Soldano amp simulation that has an RE20 miking it. I've got no drive on it. It's just a little bit of vibe, and I've actually mixed the dry and the wet signal. Now I'm going to kick on Omicide. Now I just love how that breaks up. We have fuzz on the top, we have breakup down below, and if I hit edit, you can see that there are four bands here, and the bands are being separated using these knobs, and you can see where the bands are being separated at. So down below, it's a fairly small area. In the middle, we have a fairly large area, and at the top, we have a fairly small area. Down below, we have four different types of distortion going on, so I'll solo them out for you. That's just a really nice breakup on the low end. That's some really nice overdrive. It's a model called Crest, and I have it pretty tight. And you can hear how different these distortion types are from each other. It's pretty crazy. And then way up top, I've got this, I think I may have the gate set too low or something. But there's not much content up there anyway, because it's a bass. So again, if I go back there to the mixer, here's Omicide. Here's what the amp simulator feeding it. Now, let's check out this pad. So I come down here to this pad that I created, and we have just a very standard pad, a little 80s sounding. So I decided I wanted to rough that up a little bit, you know, kind of go for more of a Boards of Canada, kind of down-tempo, chill vibe. So this is really cool because I'm retaining this kind of crackle, which is this bit right here. It's really nice kind of icy crackle that's going on in the low mids. But then up top, it's a much more standard sort of resonating filter. And it's kind of nice. It's just a tight little band that I'm doing this distortion to. And then on the very top end, I think I have another. Yeah, you see, it's very, very fuzzy. So four different types of distortion can do a lot to a sound. Giving it a lot of vibe. Below that, I have a guitar. So this guitar is kind of a Strat, and it's playing along, and have Omicide and Amp Simulator turned off. Check this out. So a very standard kind of, Strat line. Now I'm going to turn on the Amp Simulator, and it's going through a Vox AC30 with a Josephson mic on it. Instant vibe, right? Well, check this out. I'm going to turn the amp simulator off and turn on Omicide. Now that in combination with the amp simulator, it's just vibe for days. I mean, that sounds awesome. Not to mention that in the convolution reverb, I'm using an EMT 240, which is an old digital reverb. It was one of Brian Eno's favorite reverbs. And, really nice reverb model too. One of the other little tricks that I'm doing is using the SSL channel strip here, and I'm using this thing, it's a sidechain. So basically what's happening is I'm sidechaining my compressor with the EQ built into the same SSL console. So this shows you a lot of the flexibility of the SSL suite as well, and how I use the EQ and the compressor together. It's pretty cool. Just lots and lots of vibe. So up here was where I selected where that frequency was going to be that the compressor was going to listen to. And then with the sidechain on, it really goes to town, this dynamic sidechain. Pretty cool. Now, one of the most fun things that I did was the drums. So I took a very standard kit and applied Omicide to it. So you listen to the kit by itself. I did a little bit of processing here in the SSL channel strip, a little bit of EQ, a little bit of compression. Pretty standard, right? You know, we've heard that kind of a kit a million times, but pop Omicide on. So, you know, Omicide isn't just about sloshy, fat, wide distortion. You can also make it really tight. And if I go into the editor for Omicide here, this shape button lets you make the distortion really tight and focused. Or if you go to fat, it's a little bit wider and broader when it hits. Now, you also have these noise gates. And what the noise gates do is they decide when the effect is going to turn on. So you may have the effect turn on only if the kick is hitting really hard or some of the drums are hitting really hard, then the effect kicks in. And you have a standard noise gate, which gives you, you know, an attack and a release. So if your release is a little longer, it's going to give you a longer transient. If your attack is longer, it's going to come on a little softer. And Omicide is really awesome. You can also get down here into the feedback settings, and you can literally make them feedback to the point where they're oscillating and creating tones. That's when it starts to get a little wacky. But anyway, that's just to show kind of how you can have fun with something like drums, is by changing these shapes so that they're quite a bit tighter. On the very top end, I think I'm keeping it a little bit broader, but it's just a really neat way to process drums. I mean, listen to that. And when you mix it with the drum kit, it's really interesting. It's kind of weird. It's almost like a Prince song or something. Here we have Goliath open, and I've got this nice pad. I'm going to take that nice pad and make it not so nice. Let's go to the mixer, choose effects. And the first thing that we're going to use to add a little bit of drive is Amp Simulator. So in Amp Simulator, you have all these different amps to choose from and all these different mics on the amps. So I chose the Vox AC30 with the Josephson 22S recording it. It's pretty neat. We have all the cool mics like the 421, D112, RE20. Get all these cool tones. So I'm choosing this one, giving a little bit of drive and taking some of the bass out of the pad before it goes into the rest of the effects. Have a wet dry mix. I might change that later, but let's check it out. Let's turn the power off. There it is dry. There it is with a little bit of love. Now let's go to Omicide. Now in Omicide, this is a really amazing plugin. Essentially, you get four bands of distortion and you get to choose where those bands are going to be with these three knobs up top. There are all kinds of different distortion types. Up here we have porridge, soft clip, harder, stronger. We have clipping and bit crushing and all that good stuff. And then there are variations on them through the triple X and the odd. One of the neat things we can do is we can actually come up here and choose presets. And if I click on them, you can see the settings change. So let's see what Omicide does. Here it is without Omicide. And with. Now let's check out some of the different presets. So as you can see, you can pretty radically change the sound. And we start adding in things like a good convolution reverb. I'm using an EMT 240 3-second. This is one of Brainy Know's favorite reverbs. Add a little bit of pre-delay there. And then go through the SSL to add a little bit of compression and EQ. And then control it all slightly with the bus compressor. Go back to Omicide and start changing those presets again. So as you can see, the sound design options are pretty endless. You get a lot of distortion and saturation and cool stuff using Omicide. The amp simulator is really, really nice. The SSL channel strip for controlling everything and adding a little bit of transient shaping and things like that if you're using drums, really cool. Bus compressor, it's the good knob, makes everything kind of glue together. And the new convolution reverbs, there's just a ton of them. You should go through them and check them out. I think you'll really enjoy them. Anyway, that's the effects in a nutshell. You've got amp simulator, Omicide, which is a multi-band distortion. You've got the SSL channel strip, which has compression, EQ, transient design. And then you have your reverb and bus compression. And when you get them all working together, you can take a fairly normal sound and turn it into a not-so-normal sound. And for those of you who don't know about it already, I wanted to talk to you about Composer Cloud. It's really cool for folks that want to get all of the EastWest stuff, but not fork, you know, $12,000 out for the 10,000 instruments that EastWest has out. You can pay a monthly fee and you get access to everything. It's a great way to try stuff out. It's great for composers who are starting out and they want to get all the same tools as the top composers that are using those instruments. And all you have to do is go to composercloud.net. Right there, $29.99 a month. All right, take care. I'll see you next time. Ciao.